The thing is, it's not that hard to make a pretty good violin, but it turns out to be really hard to make a great violin, to bring something that lasts 5-10%. And that involves not copying, but very, very intense optimizing of any particular object. So when I have the opportunity to study an old instrument, first I want to decide, do I actually like it? And then I want to learn as much as I can about its physical structure. When I began, we would learn about the structure and of old instruments by documenting, photographing, tracing, measuring, plaster casts. Very, very much empirical documentation. As time went on, I wanted to know more about how they were functioning. And all the really important functions of the violin are things that we can't see. So in the effort to understand these instruments, I tried to focus not so much on the appearance and certainly not on the mystique, but really on how do they move? And so that's what I call the invisible violin, the part that we don't see that makes all the music. And it's in looking at the invisible violin that I began to find some modern imaging techniques to be really useful. I got involved in this project called Strad 3D. At first I was just the Strad wrangler, and I was working with this physicist, and we had this opportunity to do vibration scanning using 3D lasers on two great Strads and a Del Jesu. And from that we were able to create animations of how the violin actually moves. Many of the motions were things that you would never imagine that something made out of wood would move that way. And when I began to see that, I began to realize that this form with these curves was, first of all, much more complex than I had ever imagined. And that all these little doodads, all these little curves, they had so much more significance than anyone imagined. And then once you can see, then you can start to imagine, how would you change? How would you influence the vibration? And now when I picture the violin in my mind, I'm no longer picturing a box of wood. I'm really picturing a form which is pulsating and undulating in 100 different ways at the same time. To me, it's a much more beautiful way to look at it, and it is much more in keeping with the, I think every musician has that instinctive feeling that their violin is alive.